What's going on, my PT peeps and my Walking Dead family? Welcome to the PT channel. I'm One Eye Bri, back to talk about The Walking Dead Season 9. And in this video, we're going to cover some major potential spoilers for The Walking Dead Season 9 Episode 3. I'm going to comment about Season 9 Episode 2 and some theories, stuff that I talked about in prior videos. But obviously, spoiler warning for the first three episodes of The Walking Dead Season 9. I don't want to ruin anything for you. If you're worried about spoilers, stop watching now. And if you love The Walking Dead and The Walking Dead family, this is the channel for you. We post a lot of videos about The Walking Dead and various content, and hit that subscribe button to become a valued member of the PT channel and our Walking Dead family. And obviously, photo credit and info credit to these fine folks right here. Without them, this wouldn't be possible. But Season 9, Episode 3 is what we're talking about. Warning signs: Rick's vision for the future is threatened by a mysterious disappearance that divides the work camp where the communities are building a bridge. So, mysterious disappearance, we talk about it in a couple other videos. I have to comment about my Easter egg and big moments video that's coming out tomorrow for The Walking Dead Season 9 Episode 2. And I recorded it before I made this video, before the spoilers came out. So I might get some things wrong, but you know, it's all in good fun. And I have a theory video about setting up Rick's exit. My theory about Justin, which is going to turn out to be wrong because of the information right here from the spoiler video. But it's just a fun theory and something I could see happening. Also, the promo video I made earlier today covers some of this material. I got some of it right. Some things set for the future. And overall, it's a good video, but these spoilers give a lot of good stuff. So again, if you're worried about spoilers, stop watching now. Let's get to it. It's not the Whispers. It's not Dwight. It's not Morales. It's not Heath. It's not the Commonwealth. If you want to know who's responsible for murdering multiple saviors, keep reading. Let's get the spoilers for episode 3 started. Big thanks to Spoiler Sister for all the help. The episode starts with walkers feeding on someone. The walkers are drawn away. Their fresh kill is reanimating. Surprise. It's our barely got to know him pal, Justin. As walker Justin stumbles off, we see final warning, scrambled on the side of a building. After the intro, we see Rick and Michonne. Rick gives Michonne a tender kiss. As he leaves for the day, he places his hand over Carl's handprint. So Justin is a walker, and he was killed by people that you might not suspect. We'll get to that, don't worry, towards the end of the video. But Justin came, annoyed, pissed off people, and he's gone, just like that. Hopefully they learn from their mistakes, but they gotta get rid of annoying characters right away. Don't keep them around for a whole season, or two seasons, or three seasons, or beyond, any more than a couple episodes. But Justin is gone. Pretty crazy to think. Final warning, who put this up? Is it a Whisper connection? Is it somebody else? Is it something? Just not sure what to make of it. Carl's handprint, I think this is what they're talking about. Rick puts his hand over the blue paint, and it's inside their house, and it's a nice season 8 connection, Rick and Carl. Judith has a cough. Rick and Michonne are going to take her to see Sadiq, but promise her a family fun day. Rick tells Michonne, I can think of another way to build for the future. Michonne questions, hopefully, yeah? Rick responds, yeah. Ooh, someone has babies on the mind. Maggie is taking food over to the sanctuary. She encounters some saviors on the road. They are looking for their friends who have disappeared. There's tension, and a savior named Jed is trying to intimidate Maggie. It's the ladies, Arat and Lara, who try smoothing things over. Back at Alexandria, the Grimes family visits Sadiq. Afterwards, it's time for a montage, a family fun day montage. Rick is on all fours and crawls across the floor with Judith. Michonne gives her staff lessons. There's a picnic and hide and seek. Rick and Michonne swing Judith as she holds their hands walking down the street. It ends with story time. So Jed and the other saviors are going to intimidate Maggie as Cal and Maggie bring food to the sanctuary. This is a clip that we had from the sneak peek. We break it down in the promo breakdown so you can see Cal and Maggie on their way to the sanctuary. Cal has a gun, but why is it just Cal and Maggie? Maggie is pretty important. She couldn't send someone else to go, but I guess it has to set up things with the tension between the saviors and Maggie still. And we can't trust these saviors, especially Jed, and Justin's going to be gone, which is good. But these saviors are dangerous. You know, some of the saviors will be good, probably a lot of the workers and probably the people that are trying to calm things down. But a dangerous group needs to be eradicated. And Daryl's all about that. Maggie's all about that. But Rick and Michonne aren't. And I really hope keeping these people around any longer will not come around to bite anyone in the butt. And sometimes it does. if you don't eradicate the problem and it sticks around for too long, it comes around and causes more problems. But Jed's got to go. No word if he dies this episode or not. But for him to be causing these problems, we don't need any more trouble. But Justin's gone. I wonder how many other saviors are going to be taken out this episode and throughout the season, because we don't need the saviors and the whispers being a problem. Scott runs up and gives Michonne the report that Maggie found Justin as a walker, but it doesn't look like an accident. Justin's body is brought back to the camp. There's lots of fighting and a riot nearly ensues. Alden steps in to try to calm things down. Jed punches him, then Carol steps in with her gun at her hip. Lara also works to try to calm the situation down. Eventually, guns are drawn against the saviors. They grab axes and garden tools in response. Rick comes running in and tells them all to back off. The lady saviors, now clearly the voice of reason, talk the rest of the male saviors down and disarm them. Rick asks Father G if he knows where Anne was last night. He says she was with him on watch all night. Rick says to keep an eye on her because some people still don't trust her. And should we trust her? The fight breaks out, rioting breaks out, and it's pandemonium. Saviors versus everybody. The savior way is the wrong way. Ah, let's kill everybody. Well, there's a fight that breaks out clearly because the saviors aren't backing down. There's probably more saviors than any other group. So they have the numbers, but they don't have the weapons. And it's pretty funny that Jed punches Al in the face. Al is still partially a savior. He's not on their side 100%, but he wants to help them. Carol steps in and is like, whoa, calm it down. Jed says, shoot me now because I don't want to worry about being shot in the back. They're worried about their safety. And why don't they all just go back to the sanctuary then if they're just worried about their safety? They were safe there. They weren't getting killed at the sanctuary, right? But the fighting breaks out and that's all it kind of is, a pushing match. But Rick comes in to save the day like a knight in shining armor. Dun, 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 dun. Rick's here. Rick calms it down. They got to figure out what's going on because everybody's going to blame each other. Both sides are going to blame the other. And nobody really knows who's to blame. But we'll find out in a minute. Rick asks Maggie who she thinks killed Justin. He spots Daryl in the distance. He's heading over to question Daryl. Alden wants guns back for some of the saviors. He fears their lives are in danger. Father G talks to Anne, and we find out he lied to Rick. Gabe left after their happy fun times. Rick has a chat with Daryl. He mentions there's some people that think Daryl killed Justin. There's a nice moment when Daryl asks, why do they get this future and not Glenn or Abraham or Sasha? Rick ends the conversation asking Daryl to try. He reminds him that he once spared the man who left his brother on a rooftop to die. And that's a nice callback. Father G lying for Anne? Come on, man. Don't get trapped by this lady. She ain't no good. Anne, you can't trust her. Is it Anne or is it Jadis or both? Is she Anne here and Jadis at the junkyard? We'll find out. Daryl and Rick have a nice moment, and I'm glad to see that. I want to see more callbacks and connections, especially to season one. And all the good prior seasons. But Daryl's right. Why did these people get to have a future, but Glenn, Abraham, Sasha, they don't? I'm on Daryl's side. How about you? Everyone is in their zones, clearing walkers and talking via walkie-talkies. Maggie and Cindy spot a few walkers and report. Rick says he's on the way and tells Grid 5 to go help as well. There's walker fighting moments and Rick and co arrive. Grid 5 never shows up. So they go looking for them. They find one of the Oceanside girls was knocked unconscious. A rat has been taken. Rick tells Carol that a rat was someone they can trust, so they are going to find her. Maggie and Daryl have a talk. They are still not where Rick is mentally, but Maggie agrees he's right for the future. Daryl finds a bolt in a walker and says he knows who took a rat. Oh baby, and the plot thickens. And you can see Maggie is trying to come over to Rick and Michonne's side. Daryl is probably far from it. Daryl wants to kill the saviors. And I agree with Daryl and Maggie on their side. But I see Maggie giving in a little more easier to Rick's beliefs than Daryl for sure. It's nighttime and we're back at the junkyard with Anne. She rummages through some items and finds a metal box. She opens it and we see it's her walkie. It's Jadis. I know you are in range. I saw the helicopter last night. There's a male voice on the other end. What will you have? An A or a B? Jadis responds. What happened last night? Did you take them? Male voice replies. No pickups, but the deal stands. We have an A or a B. Jadis explains. that she's already paid her share. The mysterious voice tells her that she's already been compensated. She asks, "What will it take?" The voice responds, "NA." We find out that Father G followed Anne to the junkyard. She admits to him that she has traded people for supplies. She tries to convince him to come with her far away, but he can't tell anyone. Father G refuses and tells her he has to tell Rick. It's trouble in paradise as Jadis punches Father G and knocks him out cold. Oh baby, and we know we can't trust this lady. Jadis, Junkyard, Anne, Alexandria, what's next? She goes to the kingdom and she's Caitlin? Well, we get some connection with the helicopter. A and B, this, that, trading people for supplies. I guess that's what the deal was with Negan and the Saviors, and she wanted people to trade for supplies, I guess. I'm not sure we'll see the helicopter like this, but the A on the side is definitely meaning something. Again, I'm not sure if we'll see this shot, but Father G at the junkyard, what's gonna happen with this? And you think that Father G's got to make it out right based on the trailer over the summer with his goatee when he meets Magna and that group. Father G, what are you going to do? While searching for a rat, Carol and Rick are ambushed by Jed, the log roller savior. He has a knife at Carol's throat while Rick holds him at gunpoint. A few intense words, a head cock from Mr. Grimes, and Carol takes matters into her own hands by way of a knife hidden up her sleeve. She gets out of Jed's grasp and superficially wounds him. Daryl and Maggie stumble across a few of the Oceanside ladies holding a rat at gunpoint. It's explained that Justin killed Beatrice's husband. A rat killed Cindy's brother. Cindy explains that a rat smiled when she killed him. She says that they went along with Rick's rules because they thought they had to until Maggie executed Gregory. Maggie showed them the way. So they started picking off saviors. A rat begs Daryl to help her. Cindy makes a rat tell them what she said as her brother was begging for his life. No exceptions, a rat says. Maggie and Daryl turn around and walk away. A rat is killed. Maggie tells Daryl it's time for her to see Negan. Oh baby, that sounds so good. It sounds like a great episode again. And I gotta say, 901 was good, 902 was very good, and 903 sounds great. But not sure what happens to Jed. He needs to go. But a rat being killed, Justin being killed, means that they're not messing around. The Walking Dead Season 9 sounds great. They're learning from their prior mistakes, hopefully. And I doubt Rick's gonna kill this guy, just because Rick's kinda at that point, like, we have to work together, but how can you trust Jed after this? You gonna lock him up? Are you gonna put him in the jail cell with Negan? Are they both gonna get out? Is Jed gonna help Negan get out? And the fact that a rat is getting killed shows me that Angela Kang and the writers aren't messing around this season, and it's about time. I love it, I'm excited for it. A rat probably is one of those characters that you want to feel that she could kind of be kept alive, you can kind of trust her, and then pff, gone. The fact that Cindy lied about her hand injury, that she was cutting up potatoes, which she probably could have, but I doubt that's what it is now. She probably injured it, killing the other saviors that left to go back to the sanctuary, which is very interesting and great writing. I love it. And the fact that Maggie and Daryl are going to see Negan now is interesting. How's that going to go? Maggie coming face to face with Negan, that can't be good. So there you go, guys. That's some of the potential spoilers for this Sunday's episode of The Walking Dead, Season 9, Episode 3, Warning Signs. It sounds great. I'm excited. I'm more excited now after hearing the spoilers and reading them. And I don't even care that my theories are totally gone now, because what's going to happen in this episode totally negates them with Justin and the Whispers. I can't wait to see what happens in Episode 9 and 3. 904, 905, and the rest of the seasons. Let me know your thoughts, post your comments below. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button to become a valued member of the PT channel and our Walking Dead family. And remember, guys, with hard work, dedication, belief, and sacrifice, you can truly achieve your goals. Believe in yourself, you can do it.